as coronavirus cases spike in the U.S. Surges of the virus in many parts of Africa have begun to level off, which comes as a surprise to many international health officials. Currently, there have been just over 34,000 deaths on the continent of 1.3 billion people. Global health expert Alana Sheikh joins me now with more from Colombo, Sri Lanka, where it's almost 5 p.m. Alana, I appreciate you doing this at the end of your day, beginning of ours. Give us some context here. Why is the coronavirus response data coming out of Africa so surprising? I mean, obviously the headline is surprising, but from your perspective, the public health expert perspective here, what's surprising about it?
So, you know, I don't actually think it is surprising. I think a lot of people were anticipating a large death rate in Africa because health systems in Africa don't necessarily have the same level of funding or equipment that you might see in countries with higher income levels. But that being said, what the African health systems do have is strong public health systems and a focus on primary health care. And I think that's what came through for the Africa countries in responding to COVID-19, is that you look at West Africa, they had Ebola. They know what to do when they see the outbreak of a virus. So I think that there was some surprise to see these lower income countries responding so successfully when we've seen higher income countries really sort of flail in response. But the fact is that they had experts who knew what to do when you see a virus coming.
Alana, I know obviously that there are a lot of people who look at the data and sometimes don't quite know what that means for their interpretation of, you know, public health policy, et cetera. Just quickly, I mean, the biggest lessons we're getting here, you talk about tracing. Are we better prepared because as a global community, better prepared now because of this pandemic than we would have been before for perhaps a subsequent virus?
So to some degree, that's a choice we make now, which is what are we going to learn from this and what are we going to carry forward? And if you look at the East Asian countries who were hit by SARS, who were hit by MERS, they took that information, they learned from it, they were more prepared for COVID-19. You look at West Africa, they were hit by Ebola, they're more prepared for COVID-19. You look at the US and parts of Europe, and you know, they had a trial run with swine flu, which turned out not to be that deadly, but very contagious. We saw that we weren't that prepared. And for a while, the US had more preparedness systems. People get distracted, funding wanes, you lose those systems. So right now it's a choice. Are we going to be more prepared for the next virus? Are we going to hang on to what we've learned and keep putting the money into it? Or are we going to get distracted by the next shiny object and let go of preparedness efforts?